Like I've said before, I know this guy called Igor. He's an assistant to three scientists at the Nazzle Observatory. And let me tell you, they're hopelessly clumsy. Papaya is the absent-minded leader. Banani is a complete mess. And Ravioli, all he thinks about is eating. Igor always shares the latest disasters his bosses have caused. I was telling you about that time they almost forgot they had to travel for a work conference until the very last moment. As I was saying, Papaya and company are working at the observatory. You know, doing those measurements scientists always do. And Ravioli was talking about that apologetics book he accidentally bought secondhand. Now, they've just finished talking, and everyone is back to focusing on their work. But suddenly, Papaya smacks his forehead with all his might. The other two jump half a meter in the air out of shock. What's wrong with Papaya? Guess what? He forgot they must leave for the conference today. Papaya! How could you forget something so important? It's the Dark Matter Conference. Their work depends on it. But Papaya has a little good news, bad news trick up his sleeve. Ravioli gets the good one, which is that Papaya already bought the tickets. And Banani is left with no choice but to ask for the bad news, which is that the flight is in 2 hours. Can you believe how distracted Papaya is? 1 minute they were talking about used books on sale, and the next, they're racing against time to the airport. So they start cramming their bags with useless stuff as fast as they can. At this point, I say to Igor, hey, wait a second. Why don't they just pack the essentials? And Igor replies that to him it's still a mystery. Meanwhile, Banani and Ravioli go back to discussing the book. Banani is surprised that there could be real evidence that Jesus rose from the dead. Ravioli replies that the book seems to approach the topic with a certain objectivity. Finally, Papaya admits he's never read the Bible, which was obviously expected. At that point, Igor remembers thinking that rather than having brilliant minds, those scientists seem to have minds made of dark matter. Friends, Igor always cracks me up with his stories. And those scientists, I have no words for them. Friends, if this story was to your liking, there are many more waiting for you at Save and Blog. Check it out at saveblog.com.